welcome to the second episode of Studio Sandvik. We are very excited to be back on the air and we have a great show prepared for you today.
Yes, and we want to start by saying a big thank you to everyone that has engaged with us on the Viva Engage channel. It's super important for us to have your engagement and to get tips on stories from across the organization. So please keep the conversations going in that channel. And we will actually start with some news from the organization and from the Viva Engage channel.
That's right. The first telegram comes from the world of IT. For 2023, Sandvik set a target of a 10% reduction in carbon emissions from its IT operations. But the final result was an impressive 34% CO2 reductions, more than three times above the target. This fantastic achievement was made possible by efforts within the entire company. The saving came from replacement of the majority of routers and switches, as well as optimizing and reducing servers.
That's some really great results, and it's fantastic to see that everyone can really contribute in reaching Sandvik's sustainability targets. And we'll continue with the world of IT.
Yes, earlier today we had the privilege to talk to our Chief Digital Officer on a very exciting topic, artificial intelligence. Sofia, how is Sandvik working with AI?
In many ways right now, actually. So first, we're working with AI to put it into our products to make them more intelligent and to improve the productivity for our customers. And we're now also starting to use AI in many ways in our supply chain and end-to-end processes to make them smarter and faster and better.
Exciting. How do you see as the biggest opportunities with AI for us?
Well, I see big opportunities, of course, in what I call revolutionary AI. That is using AI to solve problems that we could never solve before, such as having self-driving vehicles in a mine or predicting maintenance by having sensors on our mining machines. But I also see a lot of opportunities in what I would call everyday AI, which is more like solving many small problems in customer service, in back-end processes, in supply chain. Both automating them, but also making better decisions. So I'm excited by both the revolutionary and the everyday AI. Mm?
But on the other side, there might be some risks as well with AI. And how do you see as the main risks and how we are preparing to address those?
Well, if I look from a societal perspective, I do see a lot of risks, of course. I mean, for example, tampering with elections and using AI to misinform people. If I zoom into Sandvik, I see some risks, but less risks and more opportunities. Risk could be, for example, that we have to be really, really good at handling and classifying information and handling private data with care. Maybe an increased cyber threat by intruders using AI. But I also see huge opportunities, mostly opportunities, that it will empower us to do new things, to be more efficient and to develop our company in many ways.
Much more to come. So thank you so much for being here today with us.
Thank you.
That's some really interesting points on how AI will impact both our company and society at large going forward.
And if you want to hear more on the topic, you can listen to the podcast we recently recorded with Sofia. It's available on home.sandvik/podcast or where you usually find podcasts.
And now an example of a successful integration across our businesses where GibbsCam, a CAM solution from Sandvik Manufacturing Solutions, has been integrated with the Coro Plus tool library from Sandvik Coromant. Torsten Strauss, who's the president of GibbsCam, will now tell us more about the advantages with this combined solution.
The excellent thing is that having this integrated, the user have access to the Coromant tools, holders, and also the feeds and speeds. And with that, programming becomes much more easy. So you can see really your individual product. That means we have a machine simulation, really the digital twin. And due to this, we can see in advance with the right boundary conditions of the tools, possible human errors, let's say. And we can find them before there's a crash on the tool or on the machine and to avoid the damage. This is an excellent example how integration should work. Because it's an absolutely win-win situation. So that means we can use Coromant technologies and tools when presenting, when using, or our customers when using our software. In the same moment, it is also an advantage for the quorum people. They can convince that quorum tools and holders are the right choice for their individual application.
And we say thank you to Torsten for that update. Sandvik Mining and Rock Solutions have signed an order with mining company LKAB to provide their Svappavaara mine in northern Sweden with new surface drilling rigs. The order involves three Leopard DI650i down-the-hole rigs that are also equipped with AutoMine as well as MySandvik on-site data analytics. This is an important step to enhance the automation of the Svappavaara mine.
And continuing with surface drilling, SMR will also provide 34 drill rigs to Country Boy's supply on the US market. The order will replace Country Boy's current contractor fleet in Georgia and Tennessee, and it's the largest ever single surface drill order for SMR.
Furthermore, SMR has signed a new framework agreement with major mining company Barrick's Gold. The new agreement covers many high-tech solutions from Sandvik, including the rollout of remote monitoring service to Barrick's entire global underground fleet. Sandvik and Barrick will also develop a long-term strategy for battery electric vehicles and define transition plans in line with Barrick's objective to be carbon neutral by 2050.
We will continue on the electrification and sustainability track. Sandvik is driving eco-efficient rock processing solutions in some of the most energy-intense industries in the world, such as mining and infrastructure. In these segments, energy efficiency will drive sustainability.
Optimized productivity and sustainability really go hand in hand. If you look at it from a big picture, metals and minerals is really needed for the green transition of our society. About 6% of the world energy is consumed by the mining sector. Of this, about 40% is consumed in the grinding process, from the ore to extract the mineral. Crush more, grind less. That's our message. All our stationary crushing and screening solutions are already 100% electricity driven. Our mobile solutions are on the electrification journey. By the end of 2025, more than 90% of the mobile offering will be available with an electrical drive alternative.
And more news from Sandvik Rock Processing Solutions. One of Sandvik's largest acquisitions ever has recently moved fully into the new Sandvik brand costume. We are, of course, talking about the mining-related business of the Schenck Process Group, SP Mining, that are now fully branded according to the new guidelines launched last year.
SP Mining has added world-class screening solutions to Sandvik and also increased the exposure towards the mining industry.
So a part of the products being really great, they now look also fantastic. We'll now move on to India. At our site in Pune, an initiative has been launched to improve diversity in the workplace. Let's learn more about it.
Since 1948, female factory workers in India have only been allowed to work day shifts. Recently, women have been granted night shifts, and Sandvik in Pune has launched a project to promote female engineers on the shop floor.
Her project is about strengthening women presence on the shop floor, not only during the general or the day shift, but also we allow women now to work in the second shift or even in the night shift, which runs from 11 p.m. till 6 a.m. in the morning.
To guarantee the female workers' safety, buses drive them to and from work.
Every women employee has given a mobile app, which she uses to show that she has reached home. This equipment actually helps us in monitoring this from the safety and security purposes.
Employees are also supported with a daycare center on site and safety and self-defense training.
If this project is not existed, then I feel very hesitated to come in night shift and work on the shop floor.
We can see that there is a good empowerment for the woman to work in a Sandvik.
Lego is something that I think most of us are both familiar with and quite fond of. I know that I am, at least. And that's why it's especially fun to present an exclusive cooperation that Sandvik has done together with Emma Friman. Emma is the champion of the Swedish version of the TV show Lego Masters.
That's right. Emma created some blueprints of items that are very familiar to many of us.
Maybe you recognize these clips from some Sandvik branding campaigns, the impossible statue, the smash-proof guitar, and the bird in the mine. Sandvik challenged Swedish LEGO Masters champion Emma Freeman Brown to make LEGO blueprints of some iconic items from the campaigns.
I was really happy when Sandvik approached me about this campaign. It was great fun working together with them and building these three projects. I started with the Bird in the Mine project. I decided that would be level one, the easiest build. The second project was the smash-proofed guitar. So I decided this would be level two, a bit more difficult, with more sideways building, so the studs are not all on top. The last project, the impossible statue, proved to be the most difficult one. There's a lot of different angles and parts to it, and to find the right shape proved difficult for me. So the impossible statue wasn't impossible to build, but it was difficult.
To create the blueprints, Emma worked both manually and digitally with Bricklink Studio 3D modeling software.
A software you can download free on bricklink.com. It's connected to a database, so it has all the different parts and you can build in the software directly. When building the Sandvik designs, my advice would be to be creative. If you don't have the exact parts, find something similar and make it your own.
And we actually have the bird with us here in the studio. It's actually really cute.
And as you see, it's possible to build this. If you are interested in trying, you can download the blueprints on home.sandvik/stories.
Yes, and by that, we will actually say thank you for this time around.
And as we mentioned before, it's really important for us to have your engagement and your stories on our VivEngage channel. So start following us and share your thoughts with us.
Thank you so much for watching this episode, and we hope to see you again in April when the next episode of Studio Sandvik will be aired.
See you then. Bye.